you would see him potentially coming back and fighting guys like, say, Conor McGregor, Khabib, you know, coming back just for those super fights. The latest rumors, Dana White has said on UFC Unfiltered that they're targeting GSP versus Nate Diaz for UFC 227. That'd be August 4th in Los Angeles. What did you think of the news when you saw that? Obviously, it's just rumors at this point. And would you expect that to be realistic for GSP to come back that soon, especially after his bout with Colitis?
Oh, it's interesting. You know, I don't have the latest on George and how he's feeling. My understanding is that he has been training again. And my other understanding is that he really wants a big fight. Nate Diaz has confirmed himself as a big fight now. I think he's a big superstar. He's an excellent fighter. He's been fighting a very long time. I don't know if George is going to find that's so interesting. I think he would probably want a rematch against Nick over Nate and possibly fight, you know, someone like a Tyron Woodley. But I don't know. You know, I think that at this point in his career, George is looking for big challenges, new challenges. You know, the fact that he might be going down to 155 pounds sounds pretty interesting. It sounds like it is a new challenge. I haven't confirmed that with anyone in their camp. When I did bring it up to one of the coaches in that camp, they seemed to be surprised and unaware about that news. But again, who knows?
Which one did you bring up? The Nate Diaz fight?
What's that?
So
the Nate Diaz fight. So they weren't really aware of it. And again, who knows? Maybe they're out of the loop. But my understanding is that they were taken by surprise and they didn't really know that was the fight that George was targeting or even wanted.
Interesting, because when he was on the MMA Hour, you know, Nate Diaz was sort of, you know, asked as far as, you know, what do you think about that fight? And he didn't really seem that interested. He spoke about how he wants to do fights for, you know, do something for his legacy. If he was to fight Nate, do you think that would do anything for George's legacy at this point, considering what he's done in the past?
Right. I mean, it's hard, right? Because, you know, George has done so many great things in this sport. He's had so many great challenges. The latest, of course, winning the 185-pound belt after being the champ for so many years at 170 pounds. So I don't know. I don't know if and while Nate Diaz is a tremendous fighter, I don't know if that's the kind of thing that he looks back on and says, you know, that was one of the highlights of my career. I don't know. And I don't think George is motivated by money at this point. He's motivated by the challenge. So whether Nate Diaz is that challenge that's going to get him to fight again, I'm not so sure.
Mm. And just for playing around and having a little bit of fun, how would you see that matchup play out, Nate Diaz versus GSP? Would you think it goes similarly to the fight that he had with Nick Diaz?
Yeah, listen, I think that Nate is a very good fighter. I think that both, you know, both of those fighters would probably be more suited to fight at 170 pounds. Mm-hmm. You know, George St. Pierre, that would be the first time that we've seen him at 155 pounds in his career, period, I believe. We know for sure he hasn't fought at 155 pounds in the UFC, but my understanding, he's always been a 170 pounder. And I don't know how he would perform at that weight. I also think Nate Diaz, his best weight class is probably 170 pounds in a lot of ways. I think he has more energy there. He's huge for a lightweight. For him to cut down a lightweight, he has to really do a lot. He's like 6'1", you know, walks in the offseason probably around 190 pounds. And, you know, he's a guy who eats healthy all the time. So it's not like it's easy for him to get down to 155. If they do fight, I would think that it would probably be at 170 pounds. But who knows? Who knows? Or maybe a catchweight somewhere in between.
And if they did fight, is there someone that you'd back over the other? Do you think it's GSP winning here just like he did with Nick Diaz? Or do you think Nate might show something new and surprise people?
Well, certainly Nate Diaz is a guy who's always evolving. He's always training. Mm. He's always getting better. But GSP is as well. And I think the kryptonite to some of the Diaz brothers' fights has been wrestlers, guys who can out-position them. Again, no matter what weight class, whether it's 155 pounds or 170, George will have a significant size and strength advantage. So that is a tough fight for Nate. I would have to favor George St. Pierre in that fight. He just doesn't make a heck of a lot of mistakes when he fights. He's very methodical. He's surrounded by excellent coaches. So that's a very smart team. I would have to give the advantage to George St. Pierre.
And I guess if the fight did happen, hypothetically, you sort of wonder how this relates to Conor McGregor. Is it a situation where the UFC is trying to set up, you know, a massive fight, winner moves on to fight Conor McGregor? And do you think that would sort of take McGregor out of the lightweight title picture temporarily? Because, you know, we do have a champion at the moment in Khabib, and this kind of frees Conor up to do other fights.
Yeah, you know, I was thinking about this rumor the other day, and that was the justification in my mind for that fight happening. Mm. That would probably be the only justification for that fight happening, would be to pit those two together and winner gets the money fight. So it does make sense. Not to say they wouldn't make a whole lot of money in that fight between GSP and Nate Diaz, but a fight against Conor McGregor certainly is a different level.
Mm-mm. And we want to get your thoughts on UFC 224 quickly in just a second. But while we're talking about lightweight and what's going on, who would you like to see Khabib fight when he returns in November, December? People are still trying to figure out who the best candidate would be. What would be the ideal fight for Kenny Florian to see Khabib fight against?
Listen, the easy answer is Conor McGregor. I think Conor was the former champion at 155 pounds. They obviously have a history. Mm-hmm. You know, it was unfortunate what happened with the Conor incident in New York. However, you know, that's your tape right there to hype up their fight. Not to mention, you know, the Ireland versus Russia thing, that would be interesting. Conor McGregor is one of the few strikers who I think can counter-strike and land a shot on Khabib as he comes in. We saw certain vulnerabilities in his last fight against Ali Aquinta. We've seen those vulnerabilities before. People just kind of forget about them. And Khabib really hasn't had to rely on his striking very much. He gets to the clinch, he takes it down, he beats you up. Rinse, wash, repeat. Conor, you know, I think would maybe find a way to land that knockout shot. Now, if he gets himself in the guard, I don't think Conor's going to be a threat to Khabib on the ground. But I do think he's a big-time threat on the feet, and Conor has the capability of knocking out anybody in and around his weight class.
Mm-hmm. It's definitely a fight that needs to happen at some point. Just looking over to this weekend, UFC 224, obviously Amanda Nunes and Raquel Pennington.